Assalamu alaikum, I'm Dr. Ali Imran. I'm the editor of the Disease Digest and assistant professor. Dr. Saab, can you briefly first introduce yourself and what work you do, then I'll proceed with questions.
My name is Sadaf Ahmed, and actually I am assistant professor at Department of Physiology, University of Karachi. I'm leading a psychophysiology research lab here, and I'm also chief executive officer of Advanced Education Institute and Research Center.
Now, as you said, that psychophysiology. Now, as a psychophysiologist, how you come across and relate these issues with the infertility in women, and what is your experience?
Actually, the infertility issue, we can relate it both with male and female infertile issues.
Okay.
And what is happening in the body is actually related with the brain. And when we talk about the chronic stresses and the environmental things and environmental aspects happening to the people before they get the news of infertility and after they get the news of infertility. So all of these stress hormones are there to just alter their physiology. Number one, if they are infertile because of some of the hormonal...
They play role in not getting pregnant at times, the psychological issues of women and men and stress.
Yes.
So
yes.
You feel like that physiology is normal, but
yes.
Psychology could hinder. Okay.
Yes.
So how you overcome those psychological hindrances?
There are certain things because there are the counseling sessions there.
Okay.
People are applying certain protocols and interventions related to the guided disclosure protocols. There are certain yoga techniques and there are also certain music therapies and exercise as well.
So you are also saying that healthy lifestyle integration might improve, and also telling them the right methodology, right time of having a relationship physical, so that the chances get increased and
chances get improved to get pregnant.
Yeah.
And people are, if they come out of their grief, so they can change their physiology. For example, one of the study in UK has published that there is a quality decrease in the quality of the sperm because of the daily stresses,
of
the mental
stress. Husband
is
like overworking and very much stressed because of the financial issues. So this, you mean sexual intercourse and physical life become difficult?
Yes,
and
even these things, and there are certain oxidative stresses as well. For example, nutritional stress is very common among our females.
Not good quality of nutrition.
Yes, yes.
So that also hinder the good ova. So what is your last message overall for everybody, especially for doctors and gynecologists and psychophysiologists, to help out these women who are
facing... What I have been doing since last 5 to 6 years is that we actually introducing the mental health aspects to the our workforce, like paramedics, like gynecologists.
Excellent.
Like other doctors. So they must know that what are the initial symptoms of these psychological aspects, and they can refer them to the psychologist.
Early health, early.
Yes, exactly.
So I'm Dr. very thankful. We will take you details, and we are glad that some mental health people or psychophysiologists in collaborating with the infertility experts and gynecologists for a better outcome of the obviously pregnancy and for family. Thank you
thank
very
you.
Much.
Thank you.